And welcome to Really Small Science Online. In this video, we're going to be making a nanopolymer bouncy ball out of just some household ingredients and a little bit of chemistry. We're going to be learning about polymers, what polymers are, what they can do, and the chemical reactions they can undertake. This activity only needs four ingredients. The first one is PVA glue. The second ingredient is bicarbonate of soda, also known as baking soda or sodium bicarbonate. Then we're going to use contact lens solution, but this contact lens solution has to contain something called boric acid. Not all contact lens solution contains boric acid, so make sure that you check the ingredients. And finally, just a little bit of food coloring to make it pretty. So we're going to start with our PVA glue. Now, PVA glue is a polymer, and polymers are very special types of molecules which exist as long chains of repeating units. There are biopolymers, such as wool, silk, and proteins, and there's also synthetic polymers, like plastics and adhesives. PVA is a synthetic polymer. It stands for polyvinyl acetate. So first, we're going to add 3 tablespoons of PVA glue into a cup. So here is our PVA glue. Currently, those long chains of polyvinyl acetate polymer are dissolved in water, and that's why it's a liquid. But by adding 2 chemicals, we are going to turn it into a cross-linked polymer, which means it's a lot stronger because those long chains are joined together by chemical bonds. But first, we're going to add a little bit of food coloring just to give our final product a nice color. Once we've mixed all the food coloring in, we're going to add our next ingredient, bicarbonate of soda. We use sodium bicarbonate in baking to make things like bread and cakes rise, and it's an alkali, which means it reacts with acid. So we're going to add 1 teaspoon of sodium bicarbonate to our PVA glue. Now, I've noticed that my glue is starting to change color from a red to a purple. Now, I think this is happening because our sodium bicarbonate is alkaline, and the red food coloring I've used must be reactive to the pH. So I wasn't expecting this. However, this color change shouldn't affect the chemical reaction, which we're going to do next. So now that we've added the sodium bicarbonate, you can see that as well as the color change, the glue has become a bit thicker and it's a bit more like a paste. However, it still isn't quite a bouncy ball. So we need to add one more ingredient. Contact lens solution. Contact lens solution is mainly salt and water. However, there are some other chemicals in it. One of these chemicals is boric acid. When we add the contact lens solution to our PVA and sodium bicarbonate mixture, boric acid is going to be released and changed to a borate ion. And once it's in our solution, it's going to react with the PVA. So we will see our cross-linking reaction take place. The borate ion is going to be used to link together those big long chains of polyvinyl acetate molecules. So instead of having PVA chains dissolved in water, they're going to be joined together as a cross-linked polymer. This is going to change the structure of the polymer and change it from a liquidy paste into a rubbery, bouncy solid. We're going to add 2 teaspoons of contact lens solution and put it into our mixture. Once we start to stir this, almost immediately we'll see the cross-linking reaction take place. As you can see, the PVA has reacted with the borate ion. Cross-linking has taken place and changed the structure of our chemicals. So if I pull this all off into my hand, it's still a little bit sticky. So I'm just going to mush it around with my hands to mix it all together. This is the fun, messy part. I'm going to add a little bit more contact lens solution just to stop it sticking to me. here we have our final product, our nanopolymer bouncy ball, which is stretchy, is squishy, and is bouncy.